What's good, guys? Your boy Luke Tavis back here for another Monday Night Raw reaction. Here's the Raw for the Elimination Chamber. Let me just say straight off the bat, Raw has been better than Elimination Chamber, even with just promos in the ring, the Braun Strowman and Bobby Lashley, the Miz promo. This is what I keep telling people about when the Miz is champion, all of a sudden there's exciting stuff. I didn't feel like this. I did feel like it a few times under Drew McIntyre. But the Miz has got the edge when it comes to on the mic. And that's fair enough. He's an actor, so of course he's going to be a lot better than most people on the mic. Good to finally see Bobby Lashley getting that push, man. You know what I mean? I have apologies for Bobby Lashley, to be fair, because when he came back... In fact, I'm not going to apologise, because when he came back to the WWE, he was trash. So I'm not going to apologise for it. You know what I mean? Came back with the headband and that. You get me? You know, trust no headband. You know what I mean? So, we're going to get into this though, Ricochet versus AJ Styles. I'm sure this is going to be another wasted episode. And you know what I mean by wasted. Because Ricochet has been wasted. The worst thing to ever happen to Ricochet was Brock Lesnar. Ricochet versus AJ Styles, I'm not expecting Ricochet to win. If he does, I would like to say it'd be massive and a springboard for his career in WWE. But chances are, if he wins, nothing will happen next week. And if he loses, nothing will happen next week. It's starting to seem like if you don't turn heel anymore, there's no place for you. And I spoke about this a while ago and said, there's no space for super baby faces anymore unless, you know, you have certain people, the Daniel Bryans and the New Day types. But I noticed about the people who can stay babyface are always really great on the mic. And to me, Ricochet is good on the mic, but not great. His style is the in-ring stuff. He's impressive at it. So, yeah, man, I mean, we went from Cedric not being able to speak much on the mic, turned heel, been great. Apollo, turned heel, he's been interesting the last couple of weeks, couple of months. Ricochet, that whole group, Ali, heel. So it seems like by the end of the year, I'm going to call it in the next month or so, Ricochet will be heel. That's the only way for him to go. But I've talked enough now. May I just put a little disclaimer at the beginning of the video for the moaners. But let's get it. Let's go.
AJ Styles was a great plan.
AJ's intense, man. Came down to the final. Nice elbow drop from Ricochet. Chamber match, ultimately falling. Like, he's a geezer, just body pop on me, bro.
And he can feel the urgency from Ricochet.
Ricochet executing quite the plan right now.
Tell you one thing, man. When
Ricochet's got to be feeling the same. It's got to be.
When you see a moss on the outside, Ricochet. I mean, AJ Styles is one of the best in the world on his own. But when you got a moss there, the game changer for real. Oh! What a move! God. No one can tell like Ricochet. Though, I'll give him that. No one can tell like Ricochet. I really want the best for the guy, man. He's actually somebody that I could see in the I know we spoke about it on the live stream, but I always thought that Ricochet and Chad Gable in the tag team would be class. I'm talking about super levels, but... Oh, he's going for that. I remember he'd done that before in the Stars Clash. I honestly would bring back... I wouldn't bring it back because it's still there, but the Cruiserweight Championship should be interchangeable between brands as well. It's on NXT at the moment and 205 Live. I think Santo Escobar has it. The great suplex. And I think Ricochet should go down to NXT, win it, and stay on Raw. And just challenge people week in, week out, because that bout is made for him. When Neville had it, the King of the Cruiserweights.
It's where Ricochet can be so dangerous. Go for the
6 foot. Oh, 6 foot. He missed it. There we go.
I was trying to set up for the recoil.
Jesus.
What a knee.
He's dead. He's dead, bro. It's over. It's over.
Ricochet might be just about out here.
And now look at this setup. Clash.
Done. It's over. I'll tell you one thing, Ricochet. Don't join Retribution. Because that won't help you at all. But there you have it. What we thought would happen. Oh god, a moss loud. What? Finish it.
Oh my god, look at the strength of a moss. Did you see how easily he picked him up?
Oh, his soul left his body. What in the jackknife chokeslam was that?
Of
what Omos is. So we're going to see it now. AJ's going to start unleashing Omos on people at the end of matches. Okay, I'm here for that still, but... And it always looks better when you lift up someone like Ricochet or Kofi because they seem like lighter guys. But damn, man. Ricochet. This is the human ping pong, man. I don't want to give WWE too much of a hard time because I don't even know what to do with Ricochet myself, but... He's better than what they've been using for kickoff shows and... Sometimes he's not even on the show. Some people are made for NXT, man. I told people this NXT style is indie wrestling. It really is. And that's what Ricochet was mad for. On the circuits, you know what I mean? Hard-hitting New Japan style, long matches. Seem kind of choreographed, but big spots. That's what Ricochet is there for. And I think, personally, you put that Cruiserweight Championship on Ricochet, because at the moment, that championship doesn't even feel like it's part of WWE at all. I say not now actually, because Escobar is actually a good champion, but he's about to fight Karrion Kross on Wednesday. I would go with getting that belt on Ricochet and let him just go between NXT, SmackDown, Raw. Then he'll give everyone a chance. I said it, but I've spoken long enough. I've been your boy, Good Savage. Comment, like, subscribe, and share. You guys have been great. Thank you so much for all the support on the channel. Thinking of doing a Patreon, not because I'm trying to make money off people like that, but I'm putting a lot of time and effort into the videos. I don't get paid anything from these WWE videos because every single one gets copyright claimed. So I might add a bit of extra content on the Patreon. If you guys are willing to join it, then do so. If not, you're still going to get free content over here anyway. I'll be your boy, so comment, subscribe, share.